Good morning. I am Shaji Vishwanathan from Thiruvananthapuram, the capital city of Kerala. Today there is an interesting article published in Indian Express today dated 30th August 2021. The article is Internet History. The article is covered the whole history of the internet. So it is written by Mr. Aravindakshan S. So just we can go through the article. The internet turns 52 in few days, though it is extremely young when compared to other technologies in the history. The internet today looks nothing like it did when it was born. What was once a decentralized network is now dominated by a few powerful tech behemoths with monopolistic control over their markets. The story of these companies can be explained by network effects, a theory that predates the internet but was famously expounded in the 1999 book Information Rules, which predicts that the digital world is mostly about size and user adoption. The more popular a tech product is, the more application and usage it will have. The rise of Facebook and Microsoft in particular can be explained by network effects. The internet is now a winner takes all market, and hence big tech finds itself under increasing government scrutiny. We tell the story of how the internet began and how it spread. That is Adesh note, and go through the history. It is starting from 1969, September 2. Techies at the University of California, Los Angeles. UCLA, UCLA, create the first net connection through a 15-foot cable between two computers. This was the precursor to the ARPANET. Okay, then what is ARPANET? The U.S. Defense Department's Advanced Research Projects Agency network that was meant to link researchers spread across the U.S. who were working on military-linked projects. Each ARPANET site had a router called the Interface Message Processor. In the picture, people operates IBM 704, a 1954 computer built to handle complex Macs. In 1954, this is the way people calculating heavy datas. So come to the next year, after 1969, in 1970, by the end of the year, ARPANET grows to 13 nodes, which include Harvard and MIT, and engineering consulting firm Bolt Brakes and Newman BBN does the tech work for building ARPANET. In 1973, ARPANET takes the first step to going global. Norway and the UK are linked to the US donors. Extent of entire internet in 1973. The map shows the whole of ARPANET, the first internet network in 1973. This rudimentary system allows researchers to log into another computer from far away, transfer and save files on the network, and send emails. In 1982, ARPANET now has 100 nodes and a relatively busy online community, a bulletin board system called Usenet is launched in 1980, becoming the first online forum which lets users post jokes, tips and receipts. In 1983, ARPANET was managed by the military in the beginning, but then the network operations realized they couldn't manage it forever. It is continued to expand in a move that would decide internet's growth trajectory. They decided that ARPANET should be recognized as a network of networks, meaning that it should be decentralized, but now can such a decentralized system be made accessible? The US military asked the computer scientist Robert Cohen and Windsurf to come up with an answer, and they developed the networking standards known as Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol, which gave us the format for transmitting data packets. In 1986, the Internet's backbone, the National Science Network founded supercomputing centers, is built up across the US, allowing high speeds for usage. It should be noted that the Internet was still tedious on navigate at the time, and simple tasks such as email were cumbersome. In 1994, the US government, headed by Bill Clinton, privatizes the internet backbone, letting commercial firms be internet service providers. By this time, ARPANET has been decommissioned. In 2017, half of the world's population has internet access. India has way more mobile subscriptions per 1,000 people, 87.3, than it does broadband subscription, 1.33 as per UN data. Digging deeper, what is packet switching? The networks that we used for voice telephones are circuit switched, meaning that while you are talking, there is an individual path in the whole network that is dedicated to you and the person you are talking to. The internet relies on a form of message switching, which allows individual messages to be routed over the network on shared lines. Packet switching improves this method further by splitting the messages into standard length packets of data. Another way packet switching made communication easier was that it used computer resources more efficiently and ensured that messages always got through. Layers of internet, TCP/IP. TCP/IP internet protocol are the bedrock because they allow different kinds of networks and devices to exchange data. These protocols are mostly decentralized. On top of the protocols is the web as we know it, from social media to online search. Tech giants such as Google, Facebook, Microsoft and Baidu occupy large searches of the second digital layer. Smartphone, cloud computing and data troves, here we can see more centralization with just two main mobile operating systems and three cloud computing companies. Some internet giants are sitting on unimaginable big and growing piles of data about us. So there is a chart internet usage. The graph shows the growth in total number of internet usage from 1990 to 2016. Below the graph is a timeline of milestones. Okay, that's all. This is the internet history. Thank you. Thank you for watching.